Russian Trump just keeps colluding. He can't stop because he's a KGB agent. And do I have to go through history? Do I have to tell you that he was suborned in the 80s when his Czech wife was probably a part of the KGB, took him to Moscow, and when he returned to the United States, the first thing he did was to pay for an ad in New York Times to criticize Ronald Reagan's very strict policy towards Russia. Now, how did this all come about? How can the United States have a Russian president? It all devolves on the stupidity and gullibility of the Americans. They are totally divorced from reality that exists in the rest of the world, and therefore it was quite easy with the modern methods of communication such as Facebook, Twitter, YouTube to influence these weak minds to elect this agent, this Russian operative, and put him in the White House. What we face is a grave crisis. Never before in America has a foreign agent been installed in the White House. And that is why I deem the Russian action an act of war in comparison with which Pearl Harbor pales in comparison. 9/11 pales in comparison with this operation. We now know was called Project Lachta, where thousands of trolls worked to influence the small, weak minds of the Americans to unite racists and libertarians to elect this Russian. We know that Trump was involved with Russians for decades. We can also say that probably, according to reports, he was financed by the KGB through Deutsche Bank. He and his son-in-law Kushner, who is a Russian Jew, they were financed and they were kept by Putin for decades. This agent has a very thick file at the KGB. His financial crimes, we only wait to see discovered. The true source of his supposed wealth, we know that, for example, the Russian agent Rybolovlev, so-called Russian billionaire, paid $100 million for a house that Trump bought just recently for $40 million, and this was in the midst of the 2008 crisis, when the value of all real estate, especially in Florida, fell precipitously. Now, when we had this mass shooting near Trump's home in Florida, he's using this to try to oust FBI Director Christopher Wray. And one of his main tasks from his KGB masters is to destroy the FBI, the primary agency that fights Russian spies in the United States, who are numerous. And Putin wants Trump to destroy these organizations, particularly the FBI and the CIA. And he is doing a very, very good job putting a crazed Benghazi fanatic Pompeo to head the CIA is only one step in this process of Russianizing and destroying this agency. When last Friday some details of the Russian operations was revealed by Special Counsel Mueller, who is a Republican, Vietnam War hero, we can see just some detail of the horrible operation that caused me last year, or in 2016, to when I check my Twitter, all I could see was that Hillary Clinton was crazy, that Russia will go into nuclear war if Hillary Clinton was elected, and that she was raping babies in a pizzeria in Washington, D.C. So if you just go to my Twitter feed on Twitter, geoeconomist@geoecom, you will find many news about what happened. A former Russian troll speaks. It was like being in Orwell's world. A former worker at a Kremlin-backed troll farm compares it to 1984 and says Americans are more gullible than Russians. So really, Americans more gullible than Russians. How did that come about? Well, they are pampered with their geopolitical isolation. Donald Trump Jr. is offering conversation and dinner to attract investors in India. My goodness. On Friday, a new indictment by Special Counsel Robert Mueller provided a comprehensive overview of a picture that had been emerging for months. Russia's Internet Research Agency, with backing from the Kremlin, ran huge troll factories where commenters using fake identities manipulated Americans' online political debates. New insight into the details of data operation came Saturday when the Washington Post published an interview with a man who says he worked at one of those factories. The Post informant, Marat Mindyarov, is not one of the 13 most high-level operatives named in the latest Mueller indictment. Instead, it was one of the rank-and-file workers who advanced Kremlin talking points in online discussions, working from a facility in the St. Petersburg area. He says he worked primarily in a department aimed at manipulating Russian citizens, for instance, by leaving comments downplaying the impact of international sanctions on the Russian economy. These messages were guided by those overseeing the operation, with individual trolls rephrasing the messages in their own words. Mindyarov says he felt like a character in the book 1984 by George Orwell, a place that you have to write that white is black and black is white. Some of the untruths were carefully coordinated to give an appearance of authenticity. For instance, Mindyarov says every piece of news was taken care of by three trolls each, who would between them perform kind of a pantomime, debate in which one would appear to be convinced of the perspective Russia wanted to promote. If it amounted, Mindyarov told the Post, to a factory that turned lying, telling untruths, into an industrial assembly line. Mindyarov says there were 300 to 400 people at the facility where he worked, but this was for a scant few months in late 2014 and early 2015, when, according to the Mueller investigation, the operation was just getting started. Dear Lord. Well, if you go to my special site, Split Institute, you will find the full text of the Mueller indictment. And you see this QAnon. Trump has ordered his Russian trolls to listen to this QAnon, with just Russian military intelligence. So if anyone wants to have some fun, you will find that very, very amusing, where you see the GRU, Russian military intelligence, telling these white snowflakes, libertarians and racists, for whom Trump's their grand dragon. He's telling them some cryptic messages, and they believe it all that Hillary will be put into Guantanamo and tortured and executed. So I have this indictment before me, and it said Defendant Internet Research Agency LLC organization is a Russian organization engaged in operations to interfere with elections and political processes. Defendants Mikhail Ivanovich Bystrov, Mikhail Leonidovich Burchik, Alexandra Yuryevna Krylova, Anna Vladislavovna Bogacheva, Sergei Pavlovich Polozov, Maria Antolievna Bovda, Robert Sergeyevich Bovda, Jakun Nasimi Ogliaslanov, Vadim Vladimirovich Podkopaev, Gleb Igorovich Vasilchenko, Irina Viktorovna Kaverzina, and Vladimir Venkov worked in various capacities to carry out defendant organizations' interference operations targeting the United States. From in or around 2014 to the present, defendants knowingly and intentionally conspired with each other and with persons known and unknown to the grand jury to defraud the United States by impairing, obstructing, and defeating the lawful functions of the government through fraud and deceit for the purpose of interfering with the U.S. political and electoral processes, including the presidential election of 2016. Beginning as early as 2014, defendant organization began operations to interfere with the U.S. political system, including the 2016 U.S. presidential election. Let's check the market just now. Go to geoeconomist.com and click on real-time stock indices, a link that is at the very top of the site. We see that the futures are slightly up, commodities, oil slightly up, forex, USD, US dollar weakening, cryptos advancing. So, still no carnage. I always say, and I think that Mueller will indict the Russian Trump only after the market crashes, because that will cleave off the libertarians from his support and make his removal quite simple. Also, on GeoEconomist, you can see that Trump has slammed Oprah. Defendant organization received funding for its operations from defendant Yevgeny Viktorovich Prigozhin. This is so-called Putin's chef, a very close KGB thief, very close to Putin, and companies he controlled, including defendants Concord Management and Consulting LLC and Concord Catering, collectively Concord. Defendants Concord and Prigozhin spent significant funds to further the organization's operations and to pay the remaining defendants, along with the other unchanged employee salaries and bonuses for their work. These groups had pages which addressed divisive U.S. political and social issues, falsely claimed to be controlled by U.S. activists, but in fact they were controlled by defendants. Defendants also used the stolen identities of real US persons to post on organization-controlled social media accounts. Well, conspiracy to defraud the United States. Defendant Internet Research Agency Agentstvo Internet Isledovania. Oh my god. The organization employed hundreds of individuals for its online operations. Project Lakhta, buying around September 2016. The organization's monthly budget for Project Lakhta submitted to Concord exceeded $1,250,000, including 1 million rubles in bonus payments. Glavnaya Linia. Oh my god. Defendants and their co-conspirators, through an organization-controlled social media account, arranged for a real U.S. person to stand in front of the White House in the District of Columbia under the false pretenses to hold a sign that read, "Happy 55th birthday, dear boss." Defendants and their co-conspirators informed the real U.S. person that the sign was for someone who is a leader here, and our boss, our founder. Prigozhin's Russian passport identifies his date of birth as June 1, 1961. Well, this is very, very, very detailed account of operations of some KGB officers, and object of conspiracy was to defraud the United States, interfere with political and electoral process. They purchased computer servers located inside the United States in order to set up virtual private networks. Use any opportunity to criticize Hillary and the rest, except Sanders and Trump. We support them. So Sanders and Trump were were Kremlin candidates. Organization created and controlled Facebook group called Secured Borders. The account specialist was criticized for having a low number of posts dedicated to criticizing Hillary and was told it is imperative to intensify criticizing Hillary Clinton and future posts. Trump train, Trump 2016, where the Trumpsters unite, fraud nation, woke blacks. Well, I have to tell you that the goal of the operation was to paralyze the United States political system, and this they achieved with putting Russian Trump into the White House. But let me warn you about something. I just lost the train of thought. What I wanted to say. Hatred for Trump forcing blacks to vote Hillary. Trump has already paid off this investment by destroying the TPP, thus curbing United States influence in Southeast Asia. And this is what the KGB officers say. They say, for example, a KGB officer at RT says that just destroying the TPP is enough for the investment that they have put into their agent, and that the intention was to put the US political system into paralysis. But I assure you, if Hillary had won, Trump would have gone on Hitler speeches throughout Ohio and Pennsylvania and Michigan and said that the election was stolen from him. So from the standpoint of American empire, you see that perhaps putting the agent into the White House is easier, because if he lost, he would be the victim of crooked Hillary, and it would be very hard to prosecute him. Now he can be prosecuted very strongly, and one hopes that that is what is coming.